Well guys, it's been a minute since I did an automotive product review, so when the folks at FIXD reached out about their OBD2 sensor, I looked into it, thought it was pretty cool, so now let's do a review of the FIXD. We'll start this video off with an explanation of what an OBD2 sensor is, then we'll go into an unboxing, it's not gonna last long, then we'll plug it in and use the app and see what you can check out with a FIXD sensor. OBD2 sensors come in all shapes and sizes, at all different price points, in the hundreds of dollars, or something more affordable like a FIXD. And what they all do is offer a vehicle health check. So if you're showing an engine light or some other code, or you're worried about the performance of your vehicle, you can plug one of these in, and with the app for FIXD, we can diagnose what's going on. This is how your FIXD sensor is going to show up, just like this. So let's start by taking off this outer packaging, which tells you all about how you download the app and the phones that it will work on, which is going to be any iOS device from the iOS 6 or newer, or a current Android device. Okay, off comes the paper. We get an installation guide with this telling you how to download the FIXD app on your smartphone and where to plug it in, the common places you would find an OBD2 port in your vehicle. So now we take it out of its plastic casing and get at the sensor. Well, super small, very lightweight. This is gonna plug right into your OBD2 port. And just in case it would get damaged, we've got some foam cushioning in there. We're not gonna need that. Let's get right into the FIXD device. Honestly, the whole process is so simple that the hardest part is finding the OBD2 port, and that's even simple. On most vehicles, it's on the left or right-hand side of the steering wheel. Sometimes it's on the passenger side. Sometimes, like in the case of this 2008 Scion XB, it's pretty much right in the center. So we're gonna reach down here, plug it in, push all the way up. Then we just hit this tap to scan button on the app. We'll communicate via Bluetooth with the scanner. Ah, I forgot one critical step though. We're gonna have to put the vehicle in accessory mode. So you push P in and crank it over without actually cranking on the vehicle. And now it's gonna communicate and we'll pull back a report. All right, the scan is done and no problems detected. Seriously?
Wait, really?
Yes. I expected this vehicle 2008 to have like so many problems. There's some code or something. It says no problems detected.
She may not look like much, but she has it where it counts.
Oh my gosh. Okay, well, are you not having any issues with the vehicle? Like it's all good?
I mean, there's no real issues. At a stoplight, she's got a good little shake going, but I just chalk that up to me not having massaging seats, and I look at it as more of a benefit.
Okay, I'm gonna ignore the fact about the massaging seats. That's ridiculous. But I can enter manual diagnostics here, so I can just hit this and say, well, see, it feels like the vehicle is shaking, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay, so, and when does it feel like it's shaking? During idle, or
yeah.
You said during idle?
Okay. Stoplight.
So during idle, and it says, okay, now it gives me a potential cause. It's not guaranteed, but the potential cause might be that the engine is misfiring in one of the cylinders. Could be engine mounts or something else, but this is one of the potential causes. And then it will give me a prompt to say, find a repair shop. So if I hit find a repair shop, it's going to look for anything in this area that has been vetted by the FIXD app, and that's awesome. Or if you have premium, you can hit this other button that says call the FIXD mechanic hotline. And what that means is that there are mechanics standing by 6 days a week and they're all based in the US, and you can talk to one of them and describe what the issue is going on. Obviously, it's not gonna be quite as in-depth as having a mechanic there looking in at the issue with you, but they can pretty much diagnose a lot of what's going on. So that's one way you can do it if you have to do it manually. But if you did have a code going on, then it will issue you a prompt saying what the issue is and how severe that problem is. Then it will tell you, do you just want to clear the engine code because it's not that big of a problem, or is it kind of a severe issue and you should go get it repaired right now? So those are some things that the app can do. And honestly, that right there, that piece alone is why this thing is worth it. Just having that peace of mind, because if you throw a code, you want to know what's going on. And if you go to a mechanic shop, you're going to like probably be, you know, ushered into getting repaired there and all that kind of stuff. And you'll probably have to pay for the diagnostics. This $20 device, with my code, this $20 device will tell you what's going on and will give you the peace of mind to know it's not a big deal, or I need to get this fixed right away. So that's one really cool thing that you've got with this app. You can also enter your vehicle history with a maintenance so that it will tell you, hey, your next scheduled maintenance, it will give you an alert, your next scheduled maintenance is going to be on this date, and it'll give you those warnings. Other cool things that are included with the free FIXD app, when you get the $20 device, you can actually see how much your vehicle is worth at this given time when you enter your vehicle mileage and your year and all that kind of stuff. And it also pulled up the prompt. It already knew based on the VIN, it knew what the make and model year of this vehicle was. So I didn't even have to enter that manually. Then you can see all the history of all your scan logs and any active recalls that are going on for your vehicle. If you get premium, you can also look up the accident history port. This is so cool if you're gonna be car shopping and you just wanna be able to plug in the FIXD and see what's actually going on with that car without having to look up the Carfax. That saves you all the money of not having to look up the Carfax. So that's a really cool feature with premium. Then you get this toolbox with things like live gauges. So if you're driving along and maybe your speedometer has failed, with this FIXD app that's and the sensor that's plugged in there, you can see how fast you're actually going and you don't need to fix your speedometer right away. And then, probably ridiculous on this vehicle, but there's a 0-60 timer. I kind of want to know what the 0-60 is on this Scion. Can we try that out later?
Well, at that point, we will have to plug it in again just to see what I blew by trying to go 0-60 on this thing.
Oh, most definitely. Yeah, but for now, we could maybe get up to 60, and I want to see how long it takes on this Scion XB, so we'll do that later. If you get premium, you can get even more. Like, it'll give you an emissions pre-check, so if you're worried, this is actually kind of worth it. This pre-check will tell you if it's going to pass effectively, you know, as close as possible, and therefore tell you whether you should go spend the money on smog or whether you should go get something FIXD before you then go get the test. That's a cool thing, and that's featured in premium. And an issue forecast. So like, it will say, hey, 2008 Scion XBs typically have this problem at this number of mileage. So you'll kind of like start to be able to budget for those things. So that's all pretty much what you can do with this app. And it's pretty sweet because it's peace of mind, right? You know what the issue is, but also, with premium at least, you can find out how much the issue is going to cost to fix. So when you go to a mechanic shop, ideally one within the FIXD app, but if you go to a mechanic shop and they say, hey, this is gonna be $1,500 or $2,000, you can look at the app and it'll say, hey, this typically is like $300 to $500 to fix, not $1,500 to $2,000, and you could be like, I'm out of here, right? Whereas normally you may not know and you may look it up and it may be very unclear. I'm really impressed with this app, and all the features that you get as standard without having to pay for premium are awesome, but the premium stuff is all kind of worth it. So I think it's time to go see how fast your Scion XB gets to 60. He's not happy about this. We're in the Scion XB, and I'll be honest, I'm a little scared that it's just gonna come apart at a certain speed.
Should be fine.
Yeah?
Right, baby? Yeah.
What is your approach for this 0-60 test? I'm just curious.
I'm just gonna go for it, man. And I, you know what, I'm gonna tell you right now, we're gonna get single digits.
No, we're definitely gonna get 10 plus seconds for this 0-60.
Single digits, I got a secret weapon.
What's that?
This car is manual mode.
You have a manual? Okay, I didn't, okay, yeah. Boy, that shift was really slow.
Okay, well.
All right, well, you ready? I'm gonna make sure that we, well, we have to be stopped. Wait till it's stopped. Okay, hit start. Ready. Car's already hesitating. And 60.
9.78, baby. 9.78. What is that? Sub 10.
Seriously,
sub 10.
I didn't see
sub 10 in the auto mode. We're cruising.
Dude, I am shocked. I thought that was gonna be a 10 seconder for sure.
It's my lightning quick reflexes.
That's actually pretty fast. Genuine surprise, genuine awe here. That's actually pretty quick for a 2008. What's this engine? It's a 2 liter, like, four cylinder. I don't know if I'm
at best.
2 liter four cylinder. Yeah. I know it makes less than 200 horsepower. It's got to be like 120. This is impressive, guys. So, wow, you can get under 10 seconds in a 204,000 mile 2008 Scion XB.
Yeah.
Okay, that's the takeaway of this whole video. The FIXD sensor is great, but 2008 Scion XB, no, I'm just kidding. So the FIXD sensor has a cool feature, like a 0-60 timer. I wanna show you this, 9.78 seconds. And guys, if you are as impressed with this little device as I am, and you wanna pick one up for yourselves, I put a link in my description, and go scoop it up for 20 bucks, I think the device is. If you use my code, you'll probably be able to find the device for the same price, not any lower, but the same price online if you don't use the code. But using the code really helps the channel out, so I really appreciate that, guys. And yeah, FIXD sensor is cool. This, I think, is the takeaway of the century, though.
Go buy the FIXD sensor just because you want the device that was plugged in to the 2008 Scion XB that broke the double digit 0-60 prediction.
Yeah. That's it. Thanks for watching, guys. We'll see you next time.